Hello, welcome to this video. Let's get a general and complete overview on all the main features inside Microsoft Project Professional 2019 in order to start using it straightforward. Make sure to check our YouTube channel and our official website to get additional tips, suggestions, reviews, and extra content for free. Microsoft Project is an advanced product used to ease the management of tasks and people inside a business environment by specifying objectives, organizing schedules, and fixing deadlines, work time, and holidays for each resource inside the team in the most efficient way. When opening Project, its startup page shows up, with your most recent project documents on the left side, and ready templates to use on the right if you want to start from a new document. To see the basics of Project, let's just start from a new blank project. The main workspace is divided in several parts. On top, you have the ribbon, collecting all the features and tools inside Project. At the bottom, you have the main project table where you edit and organize the schedule, the assignments, and the tasks. And above it, you have the timeline, which focuses on selected chosen tasks. First thing to do is to define the complete list of tasks on the task sheet on the left, and then organize and check these through time on the Gantt chart on the right. To create a new task, type the task name on a new row and define when it should start and finish. At this point, the task appears on the Gantt chart as a colored bar extended on the timeline as much as the task duration is. You can also use the zoom bar in the bottom right corner to zoom in and out on the chart, showing weeks, days, hours, or quarters. You can also double-click on the task bar to change its appearance and color. To adjust text style and general appearance on the whole Gantt chart, use the Format tab instead. You can also change the task start, finish dates, and duration directly on its bar on the chart. Click and drag the bar to move it in time, and drag from its right edge to change its duration. The task duration is measured in working days between the start and finish date from Mondays to Fridays. These are showed as white columns on the Gantt chart, whereas non-working days such as Saturdays, Sundays, and holidays are represented as gray columns. In case any task goes across these columns, this gets extended in time, but its duration and working days remains the same. To change the non-working days and insert national holidays, go to the Project tab and then to Change Working Time. Below, under Exceptions, you can add special working or non-working days with any recurrence if you need, for example, to add holidays, special meetings, or conferences. Under Work Weeks, you can specify periods of time where the working days and hours change or become non-working days. You can also go to Options to change the ordinary working hours and times. Once you go to OK, the Gantt chart updates with your changes, adding or removing gray columns. You can split a task by right-clicking on it and going to Split Task. This splits the task in two independent parts, separated by a single day and without changing the task duration. This is used to free some working hours to dedicate to a more important task. You can also add the percentage of completion by clicking and dragging from the left edge of the taskbar. This is represented as a thin line progressing over the working days. Whereas, if you need to adjust all the details regarding any task, just double-click on its name and open the Task Information panel. Here you can adjust percentage, priority, duration, and also start and finish dates. Under Notes, you can write additional comments and details, whereas under Advanced, you can fix a final deadline for the task to be respected. This is indicated as a green down arrow on the Gantt chart, and in case the task overcomes it, Project gives you a warning on the task sheet. To remove any task, just right-click from the task sheet and go to Delete Task. By default, all the new tasks created are manual scheduled tasks, with a pin symbol on the task sheet and with their start, finish, and duration managed manually. From Task Mode, you can turn these into auto-scheduled tasks, which are moved and edited by project in case these do not respect the constraints you define, for example, any deadline or limit. From the Task Information panel, you can go to the Advanced tab to add any deadline and the constraints to be respected. Indeed, you can still move and edit auto-scheduled tasks manually, with the difference being that Project assists you with suggestions to make your schedule effective while respecting deadlines and constraints. To keep selected tasks under control, you can use the independent timeline above. If you can't see it, you can show it by going to the View tab and then to Timeline. To add tasks to the timeline, just right-click on these and go to Add to Timeline. To remove these, use Remove from Timeline instead. You can add any dependence between two or more tasks by using the links. If you click and drag from any task vertically, your cursor shows a chain icon that you can move over another task to create a dependence between two tasks. By default, this creates a Finish to Start link, where the second task can start just when the previous one called Predecessor finishes. Each task can also admit multiple predecessors. All the predecessors of any task are listed under the Predecessors column with their row number. To manage links between the task and its predecessors, you can open the Task Information panel under the Predecessors tab. Each link is shown with the predecessor row number, its name, and the kind of dependence. Finish to Start is the default kind of link, but you can also choose Start to Start to start the current task when its predecessor starts, Start to Finish to begin the current task when its predecessor ends, and Finish to Finish to end the current task when the predecessor finishes. Pay attention when moving manually scheduled tasks that have links. In case the new schedule does not respect the kind of link, you will get errors on the task, shown with dashed contours. You can use Respect Links under the Task tab to correct the schedule of the current task. In the case of auto-scheduled tasks, these are solved automatically by project depending on your choice from the Planning Wizard. To remove any link from the selected task, use Unlink Tasks. Whereas, if you have any task in progress but you do not want it to interfere with other tasks or links, select it and click on Inactivate. Besides the task, you also have the Summaries and the Milestones. You can add these from the Insert section under the Task tab. The summaries are collections of tasks grouped together. When you create one, this is added in bold inside the task sheet, including the first task that was previously selected. Then you can rename, set it manually or auto-scheduled, and create other tasks within it, or include others by clicking and dragging these inside it. On the Gantt chart, summaries are shown as thick containers extended in time as much as their tasks inside are, but you can still adjust their duration in case it is a manually scheduled summary. Milestones are markers representing reached goals on the timeline. These are shown on the chart as single points complete with the goal date in bold. Summaries and milestones properties can be adjusted by double-clicking on these and using the Information panel. These objects can also include links, just like the standard tasks. Microsoft Project also has great tools to manage all the people or resources inside a team in order to assign and distribute properly the work time in the most effective way. If you switch to the Team Planner workspace, you can add all your collaborators and then assign all the tasks you have defined to these. To add collaborators, go to the Resource tab and then to Add Resource. Then double-click on the new row to define Name, Email, Group, Availability, specific working days, holidays, and the resource cost. Then you can assign any task by dragging and dropping these on the right resource row, respecting the timeline placement. Once assigned, these tasks show the dedicated resource names on the Gantt chart. In case you make bad assignments, for example, when tasks meet holidays or when overallocating resources, red contours appear. The overallocation can be resolved by using the Task Usage workspace. This workspace is used to distribute the task between the resources, considering the limits defined for the weekly and the daily working hours. In case any resource does not respect the limits, these will be marked in red as overallocated on the left side. You can resolve this by either changing the task distribution in hours on the right or using the Inspector panel to apply suggestions from project. This can also be used to apply automated corrections on other workspaces just seen. You can assign resources to task also on the Task Usage workspace by right-clicking on any task and then going to Assign Resources. Inside Project, you can extract complete reports to get a clear representation on your project and your resources status and share them easily outside. To create a report, just go to New Report under the Report tab, choosing whether to create tables, charts, or use any ready template. All reports are shown on the Report view, and you can check any report by going to Recent under the Report tab. You can also customize the report as you like with all the tools inside the Design tab above. To save your project document, go to File and then to Save As, defining destination and name. Project documents are saved as MPP file formats. In complex project managements, you may need to include a project document inside another document. You can do so by going to the Project tab and then to Subproject, browsing for the interested file. This will be added and treated just like an auto-scheduled summary, directly linked and updated to the latest version of the document. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our YouTube channel and subscribe for more free and amazing video guides dedicated to Microsoft Office Suite.